is where I wait. I guess it's strange. I never expected I'd end up here, the place of misery, my home.
I'm home.
George? I don't understand. Why? How?
Did you have a good day, Margaret?
No, how are you here?
Margaret, just relax. Don't question things. I'm sure if you play along for a while, you'll remember how things go.
How things go? What does that mean?
Here, let me remind you. Did you invite John and Alice over for dinner?
John and Alice? You want to know if I invited my sister to dinner? Of all people?
Perfect. I'm sure if you invite them over soon enough, Alice would lend a hand with supper.
Didn't you hear me? I said I didn't want them here.
Ah, lovely. Now, if you don't mind me, I'd like to go get this put away.
I don't understand. What is this? If only someone could give me some sort of explanation as to what's going on.
I'm home.
Holly?
Yeah, Mom?
I don't understand how you could be here, too. Are you
excited for Aunt Alice and Uncle John to come to dinner?
Yeah, I'm stoked.
I'm glad you're home.
Yeah, I'm going to get ready. Is Dad home?
Yes, he is. Do you know where your brother is?
How should I know? He thinks he's cool making Google eyes at younger girls.
I think I might understand, but I could swear this has already happened before. At any rate, if Michael comes home soaking wet from falling in the fountain, I'll just about have a heart attack. Jesus Christ!
Did you see that? She didn't even hold the elevator for me! And I'll bet you my bottom dollar she saw me!
You're soaked! Did you fall in the fountain?
How'd you guess? I told Jackie Walter she was pretty, and the girl went and pushed me into a fountain.
Maybe it's because she's sick of a square like you harassing her in the hall every morning.
I'm 2 years older than you. Don't start acting like you're my babysitter.
How's about you go get changed before you get sick?
Good idea, Mom. Good thing I know I can count on you.
It's almost impressive. A day in my life perfectly recreated. But I still don't get it. Why show me such an insignificant day? Why was George worried about me playing along? What'll happen if I don't?
Well, don't just stand there. Let him in!
Hiya, stranger.
Alice, how lovely to see you. And Johnny, too. You're the real stranger, pal.
Well, you know that Alice has more time to come see you than I do.
That just goes to show you need to make a better effort. Now, where's my lovely niece?
I'm here, Auntie Alice.
My, aren't you the spitting image of your grandmother? You make the namesake worth it.
Uncle John! Hey, have you gotten any letters from Cousin James?
Not yet, but I'm sure he's hard at work defending freedom.
Oh, okay. You'll let me know when he does write, though, won't you?
Tell you what, we'll call you as soon as Alice and I finish reading it.
Margaret, darling, go be a dear and put that dish in the kitchen, won't you? It'll be best to get started on dinner right away, considering how early your sister got here.
My dear, we didn't trouble you by stopping by early, did we?
Oh, no, not at all. Here, let me take your coats while Margaret gets us some drinks.
What exactly did you make, Alice?
Oh, a new recipe I found in that cooking magazine I read. What's it called again?
I didn't know you read a cooking magazine, to be honest.
Well, either way, it smells delicious. It's a shame Margaret hasn't started on supper yet. Perhaps you could start that?
A moment ago, you asked me to get you drinks. What did you prefer?
All right. Why don't we stop talking and start cooking? I could eat a horse. If we don't get dinner started soon, I'll cook.
You cooking? I'll call the fire department now.
I know this all happened before. But something about it feels fake, staged even.
Anyhow, could you please get started on dinner, dear? I don't care much more about the drinks, I'm just hungry.
I can help you, Margaret. Wouldn't that be nice?
I don't care what you do, I've seen enough. I want to leave.
You're a riot, Margaret. Let's get supper started, shall we?
No, we shouldn't. Just stop it already. I don't understand why you're making me go through this again. I know what happened that night, but it was almost 4 months ago. Why show me this instead of something more recent?
Margaret, I thought I told you to play along. All you had to do was follow your role.
Stop it! I don't understand what that means!
We all play our parts, Margaret. It's time you do the same. Don't you want to help the family?
No, I don't want any of this! I know what happened that night. John and Alice came too early, I didn't have supper started yet, and George got upset. In the end, dinner was a disaster and everyone started fighting. I told Alice to never come here again and ran to bed. Michael and Holly ended up cleaning up after dinner.
Don't you want to be a good wife and mother?
I don't know!
I'm afraid your mother's not feeling very well.
Is this about last night with Aunt Alice?
Your mother and Alice have never gotten along. Not really.
I know, but Aunt Alice is so nice. I don't understand why they don't.
You're right about that much. You know, I actually met your aunt first.
Really? What was she like?
A little bit louder, a little bit meaner. I'll admit, I had a bit of a crush on her.
But man.
But then I met your mother, and I fell head over heels in love.
Was Mom much different back then?
I think it's about time you go to bed.
Good night.
Good night.
I heard what you said. It's true. Alice and I have never gotten along. Not really. Even on the better days, she still found ways to bother me. Little insults hidden in false compliments that pricked my skin. Everything. Even the condescending way she offered to help with dinner last night.
And you believe she's actively trying to hurt you?
Do you think I'm wrong? Do you think the entire reason I'm here is to pay for this?
Margaret, I...
Look at me, George. My whole life, all I've ever done is blame Alice for the flaws in my life. She got married first. She has a nice house. Her son is fighting in the war. What do I have?
Don't say that. We have a wonderful life and two wonderful kids. The only person whose life should matter to you is your own.
But what if I'm not happy with it? See, it's not just me. I'm so unhappy here. I've always been. I'm stuck here all day with nobody. And then when you all get home, it's like you don't even realize how empty my day is. I cook, I clean, I sit and wait for you all to get home because if I don't keep a perfect house, all hell breaks loose. And you never thank me for it.
Margaret, please! I work hard all day so we can pay the bills and be happy. Holly and Michael get good grades. They're all around good kids. I'm happy that we're happy. Why can't you be?
What the hell? I thought that last night was just a dream or something like that. A vision, most likely. I expected to be done after I ran to bed. But a whole day has passed, and I'm still here. Why? What possible use can I have for meaningless arguments? I don't like it. In the moment, it almost felt real. It's been happening so much lately. When I get too into things, I start to forget that they're only memories. That I'm... Oh my God. Is this what I think it is? It must be. Who else is called so late, especially after that fight? I know what this phone call is. Hello, Alice. A little late for you to be calling, isn't it? Of course. I'll go get him.
That's all I'm saying. He ought to stay in his lane if he knows what's good for him.
And who is this?
The postal clerk. That always makes me want to stop writing to my mother. I just wish she'd get a telephone.
You wouldn't believe the shovel Alice and I had to get my mother to get one. Now, help me get these groceries away. Thank you so much. I couldn't do it without you.
I'm going to ignore that. How was dinner the other night?
With Alice? I've had better.
I'd say. I can almost hear the shouting from my apartment.
Now don't you exaggerate. I'll doubt you were even up that late.
Oh, you sure know how to make them sting. Excuse me.
Finally, you give me a day I'm happy to relive. I had so much fun every time I was with Ruby, I almost forgot how much I detested my life. If only the whole day had been as good as our time out.
Now then, you said something happened last night?
Here goes. Alice called late last night.
To apologize?
My sister apologizing? only things work like that.
Then why did she call?
Your guess is as good as mine. She called for George.
Your sister called you in the middle of the night to talk to your husband? Call me crazy, but that doesn't seem usual.
It's not. I have no idea what it meant.
Did George say anything?
Only that she called to ask him a question about our dinner the other night.
And you don't believe him?
And you do?
All I'm saying is maybe it really was a question about dinner. You said you got into a fight. It could have been about that. Well, don't you think I might be right?
I'm not saying you're wrong. Just hoping it. I never did get the chance to find out what that phone call was really about. Maybe if I'd chosen to believe Ruby, to believe George, then I wouldn't be here today. But then again, that phone call was the least of my worries.
I'm home! Hello, Ruby. I hadn't expected you to be here.
Time must fly when you're off being busy in the man's world.
Yes, of course. Are you feeling better, dear?
No.
Oh, yes, you are. Did anything exciting happen today?
I wouldn't know. The only thing I did today was buy groceries.
Exactly! If we didn't have you, who would buy the groceries? I trust you didn't get her into too much trouble.
I hardly think anything I do would be anything but trouble in your book.
Now then, Ruby, you can't pretend to hate me forever.
I can try.
They used to be able to go on for ages like that. George refused to believe that anyone could hate him, especially his wife's best friend.
Come now, Ruby.
But I could never tell if she actually hated him as much as she put on. Or even more.
I have to go.
Goodbye.
What the hell, Margaret? I try all I can and she still hates me. I wish you'd at least tell me when she was gonna be here.
I don't have to tell you what I plan to do with my free time. It doesn't concern you.
It concerns me when it happens in my house.
It's my house too, George. I know you don't like her, but that doesn't mean you have
to- Margaret, we've talked about this.
What's this? The fact that you don't want me to see my best friend? I've known Ruby for longer than you've known Alice.
You know that's not what I meant.
Then what did you mean?
I mean that we talked about how every little disagreement between us turned into a fight now. Look, I understand. I may have upset you when I got frustrated, but you could have just told me she was going to be here. I don't like fighting with you, sweetheart.
He always said that, and we still always fought.
Now, Robert from work and his wife are going through similar issues, and after going to counseling, they...
Counseling? What the hell are you talking about?
Marriage counseling. We go in, talk about our problems, and the counselor helps us fix our marriage. Why won't you just give it a try?
Because I don't think talking to some man we've never met about our marriage is a good idea. What happens between us is our business.
You say that, yet you still tell Ruby. Don't tell me you two weren't talking about me.
George, I don't want to talk about it right now.
All right, then. I understand.
Where are you going?
Out for a drink. I'll be back later.
It all still feels so real. I don't like it. And I just get so into things. But that doesn't matter now. I think if I want to get through this, I have to keep going. I can relive 3 months, can't I? It's not like I haven't already gone through this before. I know that as soon as Holly gets home, I'll go to Ruby's. And I know that George and I will fight about it when I get home. And I know that getting through this again is going to be hell. May as well come in now.
What were you doing?
Collecting the laundry, so I expected Holly would get the door.
Is she here too?
Hardly. She's been in the bathroom for over an hour now.
Mom, don't make it sound like that.
She's obsessed with trying new makeup looks. She's convinced the trends are going to change soon, and she wants to stay ahead of the time.
It's just the two of you here?
Of course. I was suspicious of Alice even then. I always assumed that she and George are trying to get me committed.
How are you, Margaret?
Well, I suppose I've been better, but then again, I'm supposed to say good, aren't I?
I'm fine, thanks. Anyhow, I wanted to apologize for dinner last week. I'm sure if John and I hadn't been so early, you wouldn't have been under so much stress.
My God, has it really already been a week? I guess when you get so into things, it's hard to realize how much time has passed. Don't worry about it. I'm sure I would have been shocked either way.
So you're not mad at me?
Not yet, at least. Are you all right? You're looking around like a madman.
What? No, I'm fine. I just wasn't expecting you to be here.
Well, where else would I be? And besides, George is working late. I wouldn't want to leave Michael and Holly alone.
Is Michael here too?
No, he had to stay after in school. He's not doing too well in English.
Or math, or science, or any other class.
Holly, please! Did you have this much trouble with James when he was younger?
Well, James was always a well-behaved child, and being an only child must have made it easier. He had no one to compare himself to.
You know how much they look up to him, right?
I do. I'm just so worried about him. Do you think he'll come home?
Of course he will. I can feel it.
Some days it just feels like he never will. I can't lose my baby boy, Margie.
And you won't. Here, I'll get us some coffee. I just started the pot not too long ago, so it should be ready by now. How do you take it?
Just some sugar, please.
You know you can always call me whenever you're worried, right?
I know. I guess I'm lucky to only live a cab right away.
Yes, we're lucky to have family so close. Not like Ruby. Her mother moved to Michigan and her brother's still upstate. Not that he ever talks to either of them. It's good to have family. Did I really believe that then? Or even then, was I just saying it like I am now because I knew I had to? Do I have to? Why do I have to do any of this? I could leave, couldn't I?
Nearly 5:30. God, you scared me lying on the ground like that. What happened?
Alice came over earlier.
Did she? How come?
She came over to talk about something. I don't really remember.
Well, all right then. I'll be right back.
Christ, my head. I don't remember having such a migraine lately. Then again, I don't remember that conversation with George either. I changed things. I wonder what happens when I change what happens like that.
That sounds great, dear.
What?
The meatloaf! That sounds great, dear.
What?
Margaret, please get started on that meatloaf.
I guess this is what happens. Ow! God! Stop! Stop! I'll make dinner if that's supposed to happen! Just get out of my head!
You just keep working your magic, dear. I'm starved.
It's getting better. I'll make the goddamn meatloaf if it means that much to you. George, why am I doing this?
Because you make a meatloaf to rival my mother's, dear.
You know that's not what I meant, but I guess you'll never say anything, will you? What's the point? I've been here for a week, and I'm already no closer to finishing this nightmare. How long will it last? When can I stop and get on with whatever else I should be doing. I can't do this. I can't face my children every day like this. When things start to happen, I can't imagine what life would be like without them. I miss them. The real them. Not just memories repeating themselves again, but new memories we can make together. Looking back on it, we really don't spend enough time together.
Margaret, dear, how's that meatloaf coming along?
Just fine.
Really, Margie, relax. You've been about this for weeks.
You don't understand. I'm trapped.
I know. You're trapped in your marriage, and as much as I hate George, too, you've got to give it a rest.
She doesn't understand. She never will. I thought that if anyone could understand, if anyone could say something to acknowledge what's been happening to me, it'd be Ruby. She's always been my most trusted confidant. I just knew I'd get her to say something. Ruby, please. I know you can hear me. And I know we don't have much time left together. Please.
How is the old card anyway?
We had another fight last night. I just don't know what I'm doing wrong.
Darling, no, you're not doing anything wrong. He just needs to learn how to make a better effort. Here, tell me what the fight was about.
Well, I've been upset because he's been going out a lot more often lately.
Out? With who?
I don't know, his friends from work. He never introduces me to these people or even tells me who he's with.
And you're sure it's just his friends?
Of course. I trust George, unlike you.
Whomever I do or do not trust is hearsay.
But you're right. I wouldn't trust a man who claims to go out drinking every night with friends you've never met.
Is there any records, or do you just have radio?
We have a record player, but it's in Holly's room. I don't know where George put our records, though.
You'd think I'd be able to listen to quality music around here, not just the junk they play on the radio.
Ruby!
What?
Can we talk? I mean, really talk. Please.
Of course. What do you mean?
About George. I'm worried. He trusts me less than I trust him.
It's okay, Margie. I'm sure it's just because he knows he has something to hide. Half the time, when a man calls a woman crazy, he's just compensating for not understanding women.
Ruby, you're the one who sounds crazy, but I guess you're right.
I'm always right. Listen, call me the next time you and George fight. I want to be here to back you up. Speak of the devil.
Ruby? I'd like to speak to Margaret alone.
Anything you have to say to her, you can say in front of me. We're all adults here. Let's not act like immature school children.
All right. That's fine by you? Okay, then I'll say it. I think you're being unreasonable.
Excuse me, she's being unreasonable? You're the one who's come home and out of nowhere accused Margaret.
Stop that! You told her we fought last night, didn't you? She must not have told you everything then.
Which is?
Last night, I went out with a buddy of mine, Steve. Celebrated his wedding anniversary. Been married 25 years without so much as a petty dispute. Margaret didn't want me to go out.
Did you even give her a chance to explain herself?
Of course I did! I heard out her whole side and even tried to appeal to her logic a bit. But she wouldn't listen. I guess I didn't realize going out for drinks once or twice a week was illegal.
Oh, just stop!
Still, George, don't you ever think about why Margaret gets upset?
Yeah! She gets to spend her days gossiping about me to you, but the second I want to unwind with a buddy, I'm the bad guy.
Do you talk to Margaret, try to come up with a compromise? Maybe you say-
You just watch your mouth and mind your manners, Ruby Dooley. The last time I checked, this was my marriage, not yours. Let me and Margaret handle this, please!
Goodbye, George. Margaret, trust I'll be seeing you guys again soon.
Now will you talk to me? Jesus, Margaret, you can't let Ruby fight all your fights!
I'm not letting her fight my fights! There's nothing I can say to you that I haven't already said. You don't care about me, George. You never ask me how I feel about things.
Oh, why don't I ask you right now? How do you feel?
Right now, I feel upset and angry and mad.
Right. Anything else to add to the list, or will mad and angry do just fine?
This is what I'm talking about! You don't take me seriously!
I take you plenty seriously! Would you rather I come home every night in a drunken rage and beat you? Would you rather I left you home alone with 10 kids to take care of while I'm out hunting all day or fighting in a war? Because I can do that, Margaret! I can leave right now and enlist and leave you with no money and a corpse for a husband!
Don't say that! I can't believe you would say that, even if you're just joking. You're lucky Alice isn't here to hear you.
You're right. I'm sorry. I shouldn't have said that. I'm too old to enlist anyway. Not the strapping youth they need.
Oh, don't say it like that. You're still twice the man they need. You don't look a day over 26.
Margaret, please, I'm over 40 years old. Look, I'm sorry. I know I shouldn't have gotten so upset right from coming home like that.
I'm sorry, too. I should have asked Ruby to leave when you asked to talk, and I should have had a civil discussion with you.
I'm glad we've both come to realize we're at fault. Now that we're here, will you please consider going to counseling again?
George!
Margaret, please, I know how you feel about it, but I love you. And if marriage counseling will help us solve our problems, I'm willing to go.
George, we've talked about this. If we don't go to counseling, they'll just tell you I'm crazy. I don't want that.
Well, maybe they're right.
What?
Maybe you are crazy. Wouldn't you like to know? I'm gonna go get changed. I love you.
I know. What the hell? It's like no matter what I do, I'm the one who gets punished. I'm not crazy. I never was. Ruby's probably right. It's probably just that George is exaggerating, making things up to make himself sound better. I don't know how much longer I can do this. When things get going, I start to forget what happens next. Even now, I'm helpless to-
Oh, and Margaret, Alice called while I was at work. She and John are gonna come over tomorrow afternoon.
Tomorrow? But
that sounds great, dear. We'll see you soon.
Just what I need. At work? Alice would have had me know I'd be home. Why would she call George first? Presumably, yes, not to upset me. Let George break the news himself once it's too late to decline. Goodness, I wonder what she could possibly want to flaunt this time. I should start supper.
And then, get this. He says, I didn't realize you meant paper. Unbelievable. Isn't it unbelievable, dear? Oh, Christopher.
Well, I'm a tad ashamed to say that nothing that exciting happens at my job. What is it you do again?
George works for the newspaper, remember, dear?
Oh, right, of course.
That's right. I work in advertising. Not an ad in the Times that I haven't procured. Of course, I don't get much time to read the articles. I feel bad. I come home and frantically reading the very paper I helped create.
Oh, what an insightful story.
Well, I certainly think so. Didn't you think so, dear?
Oh, right, yes. The paper is fascinating.
Anyhow, I've stolen the show for long enough. Johnny, old boy, you must have a story of your own to tell.
Oh, yes. Why don't you tell us a story, John?
No, I'm afraid not that much interesting happens at the firm.
Oh, now don't say that. There must be much that happens to you.
No, not really. Sorry.
John. There comes a time in a man's life where something that may seem average or mediocre seems satisfactory for a story he tells his wife and brother-in-law. Someday that may happen to you. Well, that ship has sailed. Margaret, dear, do you have anything you'd like to add to the conversation?
No, I don't think so.
Oh, no, please, I insist.
Well, I'm afraid I don't have any stories to tell. None that you haven't all heard, anyway. You know, I mostly sit at home all day, and I wasn't really planning on being involved in the conversation today, so...
Oh, come now, Margie. I'm sure you have plenty of stories to tell. Who's that friend of yours from growing up? Renee?
Ruby.
Right, Ruby. Do the two of you still talk?
Yes, but I don't think George and John want to sit here and listen to us discuss matters such as those between us women.
Oh, no, by all means. If you two would like to talk about your friends, as I've known women to do, I'm sure John and I can invest ourselves in other matters. Here, why don't you two go talk in the kitchen while John...
No, George, I said I don't want to talk right now. Can you please respect that?
Perhaps going out for a nice dinner would be a good idea then? We could take Holly and Michael or leave them here, whatever you want.
That sounds nice. John?
Oh, yes, that sounds great.
Margaret?
All right. I think Michael and Holly are responsible enough to be left here alone.
All right. I'll go grab my wallet and let the kids know.
I thought that going out would be good for us. We've been so tense lately, and the conversation at home was beginning to drag on, listening to George's work stories. Yes, it would be good. Then maybe I could relax and have a drink for once. I was looking forward to it so much.
Thank you. Of course, darling, it's what I'm here for.
No, not just for that, for agreeing to go out. It'll be so nice.
I know what you meant, Margie, and I mean it. I'm here for you. And dinner will be nice. We can talk about our plans for Thanksgiving then.
All right, the kids are beyond excited for a night to themselves. They're gonna finish their homework, Michael's gonna watch some television, and Holly's gonna call some of her friends on the phone. Let's head out.
Hello? Oh, hello, Ruby. I was just about to head out to... Oh my God! That's terrible! Is she all right? Oh my... Do you want her to... Tomorrow? Yes, that sounds all right. I love you too. Goodbye.
What's wrong, Margaret?
It's Ruby, her mother. She's had a heart attack.
Oh my God. Well, did she live?
Yes, but she's in critical condition. They think she'll stabilize by tomorrow. Ruby's going to come over tomorrow and tell me more.
Poor thing, you'll have to send her my love.
Yes, I will. But I don't want to delay dinner any longer. Let's go.
All right, let's go.
I love you.
I love you too, darling.
Are you gonna be okay?
Of course I am. It's just, we need to stay strong. For Ruby. She's probably going to be taking a trip to Michigan to see her mother soon, so we need to be accommodating.
Accommodating? How should we affect her trip?
Are you that dumb? These are tough times for her, and we should be there to make her feel calm and welcome.
That's right. Get to school.
Are you as worried as I am?
About what? Ruby's mom?
No, our mom. This isn't the only thing that's been stressing her out lately. She's been stressed for weeks. And you have to have heard what Dad's been saying.
No.
Are you serious? Your bedroom walls must be thicker than your skull. Whenever Mom and Dad fight, which has been a lot more frequently, as some people have noticed, it always comes down to one thing.
Which is?
Dad thinks Mom is crazy.
Shh. Keep it down or she'll hear us. We don't want her getting more upset than she already is.
So you agree with me?
Agree with what?
Dad says Mom is crazy, and she's been so stressed out lately. I think something bad's going on, and if it's not, it's going to. Let's go.
So we're here. After weeks of this godforsaken double take, I end up here. I wonder if I'm more nervous than I was last time. I wonder if Michael and Holly noticed it.
Margie, I can't believe it. I can't believe my mother.
Shh, here, let me take your coat. What happened?
Almost funny. One of the only times Mother's ever spoken to me on the phone.
half asleep after a heart attack.
Is everything okay?
She was at the supermarket to stock up for the holidays. She was only in the produce section, third section on her list, when she collapsed looking at the oranges. Thank God it happened there and not at her house. She doesn't have a phone. Who knows what could have happened? That's why I'm taking mine with me when I go.
Oh, come now, Ruby. Even you can't possibly justify bringing a phone for just a short visit. Ruby, you can't!
No.
Is it true? Are you really moving all the way to Michigan?
Have to, Margie. I'm leaving tomorrow.
Tomorrow?
Just have to. I can't be this far away from my mother anymore. Just in case. I don't want to leave you, Margie. I don't want to leave you here miserable, and I especially don't want to leave you here with George. But I have to. If I could, I'd take you with me.
But you can! I'll go too. Not forever, but for a while.
No, Margie. I have to put my foot down. You have a life here, darling. All I have here is you. You have your kids and your sister. All I have here other than you is my mother. And me being with all I've got can't take you away from all you've got.
I know, it's just, I'm stuck here. Stuck in a life I don't want.
I know, but think of all the good things you have here. You have Holly and Michael, and you're such a good mother.
I know, and they deserve so much better than the mother who doesn't even want the life they're in. But I'm trapped here. The only way to achieve escape is to die.
Don't say that. Don't you dare say that, Margaret. Death, escape, you're thinking too negative. What you want isn't escape. What you want is freedom, and freedom is a choice. People choose to be free every day, Margie. You can too.
No, I can't. As long as I've got a purpose here, as long as George is here, I can't go. Not as much as I want to tear everything up and go with you. It wouldn't even have to be just me. I could take Michael and Holly to Michigan, and I'd get a job to support us. But with George, I could never have the guts to leave.
God damn you, George. Well, at least I know you're too level-headed to do anything crazy. If it were me, George wouldn't last the night. And we're always better off without him. I have to go.
Ruby, no, you can't.
I'm sorry, Margie. I have to catch my train.
Ruby, you're my best friend. You've always been there.
I'll still be your best friend, Margie. Just a few states away. Love you, Margaret, more than anyone else in the world. You know that, right? I wouldn't have come here to say goodbye if I didn't love you. This is one of the most painful things I've ever had to do. But I am not leaving you. I will not disappear from your life. We'll be back.
I know.
Love you.
I love you too.
Bye, Margie.
Goodbye, Ruby. Ruby was wrong. Freedom isn't a choice. Freedom is a gift given to a solemn few. I'm done! All these memories are doing is taking and taking! I need something that gives! Ruby was all I had! If I had known when she left that day that I would never see her again, I would have done something different! Something, anything! I would have done everything in my power to get her to stay! But here? Here I couldn't so much as grab her hand before the pain became unbearable and she slipped right through my fingers. I could have gone with her. I could have left right there and gone to Michigan, and then I would have had my best friend still, and maybe, just maybe, I wouldn't be stuck here. Throw your worst at me, go ahead, but I'm leaving. I'm going to find Ruby and I'm going to get my best friend back.
Understand why your mother's so upset. Ruby called the other day. They spoke on the phone, but She's grieving as if she's died. It's almost as if they both died.
Is Mom gonna be okay?
No way of knowing. I can only hope so. Could you get me a drink, darling? I'm just thirsty. Water's fine.
Do you think she's crazy?
No, not at all. Where would you get such an idea?
Well, it's just, that's what you say whenever you two fight.
Michael, here's a lesson for me to you. Never listen to what your father says about your mother, and never call your wife crazy. Because God knows a woman will start to listen and actually become crazy.
Well, yeah, but Dad, all you've been doing lately is fighting. Maybe if you try...
Don't you think I try? Don't you think I do everything I can to make her happy? I've tried it all. Marriage counseling, nice outings, everything that ought to cure a woman of this affliction. But nothing works. I'm sorry. I know I shouldn't have brought you two into this. I know how it affects you. Alice was right.
Where are you going?
Out. Someone I need to talk to.
Where'd your father go?
Out.
He said he needed to talk to someone.
I think things might be taking a turn for the worse.
We know.
We keep hearing you guys fight, and...
It's not good for us. Any of us. I'm sorry. You two deserve so much better. You're all I have.
That's not true. You have Dad.
And I'm Alice.
Hey, how would you feel about possibly going to see Ruby?
Really? When?
Well, not until after Christmas, but I think it would be nice to go. Just the three of us.
Just the three of us?
Yes, I think some time away from your father might be good for me. But I want you two to be there. It could be nice.
Well, yeah, but...
I should start dinner. What am I doing? Acting like everything's fine? It's not. It wasn't. I wasn't myself that day. What did I do next? I can't remember. What did I... I'm sorry. I'm not thinking straight. I haven't been lately. Things have been so different.
We know.
Don't say it like that! That's what your father does! He thinks that just by pushing me and brushing things off, they'll be fine, but they won't! Things aren't fine! I'm beginning to wonder if it's not even my fault! I've always said I felt trapped here, but he just says I'm making things up! He's the reason I'm like this! He's...
Mom, please. We're here for you. We love you. Everything's going to be okay.
Things are tough right now, but we'll get through this. We always do.
But how? How can I possibly overcome an obstacle? The obstacle is me.
I don't know. We'll do something.
Holly, something isn't enough. I need a miracle or something like that.
Then it's settled. We'll just find a miracle.
Michael.
What?
What's wrong?
That. It's not right. We have to do something.
Dad said Mom won't go with him to see a doctor. Besides, we're only teenagers. What can we do?
Nothing. Nothing at all.
My God, Margaret, I've got it!
Please close the door.
What?
You were gone a while. Where were you?
Oh, never mind that now. I got it. I know it'll make you feel better.
You've brought Ruby back?
No.
Oh.
I brought Alice.
Hi, Margie. What the hell are you trying to do?
What? You said you wanted to be happier, so I'm trying to get you to socialize more. Please, make yourself welcome. Would you like anything?
No, I'm fine. Margaret, George told me how you've been feeling down lately.
Yes?
Well, I thought it would be nice if we could spend some time together. Just the two of us.
All right, I've got you two girls. I'll leave you two to some time alone. Goodbye, girls.
Well, Alice, I'm glad you're concerned, but I'm fine.
Are you, Margaret? Are you really fine?
Alice, when I say I'm fine, I mean I'm fine. I'm not a little girl anymore. You don't have to protect me.
Yes, I do. I'm your big sister, Margaret. No matter how old you get, whether you're 9 or 90, I will always be there for you. Why can't you just trust me?
Why can't I? I don't know. I've never trusted Alice. 20 years earlier, we got into a fight, and I swore I'd never speak to her again. But a few years went by, and the kids came along. It just seems silly to keep them apart like that. But why? I don't even remember what the fight was about anymore. It had something to do with George, probably, but it was stupid. But lately, I've just felt so uneasy about Alice. Almost the same way I felt uneasy about George. Like they're both plotting something behind my back. In the same vein that George calls me crazy, Alice manages to get under my skin without outright saying what she means.
Come on, Margaret, you can't avoid talking to me. Tell me what's wrong.
No, why don't you tell me what's wrong?
Me?
Yes, Alice, why don't you tell me what's wrong? Why you're really here?
Fine. You want to know what's wrong? You have everything you could ever want. You have a nice apartment in the city. You have two amazing children who are here, not on the other side of the world. You don't have to spend every night crying yourself to sleep because you don't know if you'll ever see your son alive again. You have an amazing husband who cares about you so much that he took time off of work just to make sure that you're okay. And what do? You push him away and you complain, all because your best friend moved away. Earth to Margaret, your life is almost perfect. The only thing you seem to care about is only a phone call away, and you're acting like it's the end of the goddamn world. Take a look at yourself and then ask me what's wrong. George spent all day talking about you. Told me how worried he is about you. You won't even talk to him anymore. There's so much more you could be doing than laying in bed all day and feeling sorry for yourself. You don't appreciate your husband. I didn't when we were younger, and he chose you. George is a great man. You need to recognize that.
Christ. Is that really how you feel about me, Alice? Could you give me some time alone? I just need to think. George? George, I'm home!
Margaret! Oh, I was worried sick when you weren't there when I woke up. Where were you?
I went for a walk.
A walk?
Yes, I just wanted to get some fresh air. I'm sure you could understand.
That's great to hear. What's this for?
Oh, that's a surprise.
A surprise? Whatever for?
Well, it's almost Christmas time, isn't
it? Oh my god, Christmas! I've been so worried that I almost completely forgot.
We didn't even have a tree.
Oh, never mind that. Getting a tree this time would be nearly impossible anyway. For Christmas time, is it? Guess that means you're back to your old self again?
Yes, I just wanted to make it up to everyone for being so down lately.
Perhaps going out for a nice brunch would be a good idea.
Could we? Oh, that sounds lovely, dear.
You heard your mother. Go get dressed. I love you.
Yes, I know. Now go get dressed. I don't know how much longer I can keep up with this. It's only been one conversation, and I already feel drained from lying. I don't even know why I'm doing this. Prove something to Alice, I guess? But why? Why do I care so much about what she said? Why should I care? It's something about what she said. It got to me.
What the hell? Why would you throw this? Margaret? Margaret, what's wrong, darling?
It's Alice! She came in here the other day, and do you know what she told me? She told me that my life is perfect and I'm thankless for it. She told me that I have everything I could ever want, and all I do is lay in bed and feel sorry about it.
Well, don't you?
Don't I what?
Don't you have everything you've ever wanted? I've done my best to make you happy, Margaret. I fell in love with you because I loved how you were when you were happy. As a younger girl, Alice always wanted more, but you were always happy with what you had. I fell in love with you because I loved how you were when you were happy. In these past few years, I've been doing my best to make you even happier. I got a nice job so I could buy us this nice apartment, these nice things for the kids. I always made time for you in my schedule, and anytime you've asked for something, I've done my best to get it for you. But this I can't get you. I can't go to Michigan and bring Ruby back. I can't take away any feelings of jealousy you have over Alice. I can't make whatever's causing you to be upset now just go away!
I'm not jealous over Alice.
Yes, you are! That's all you ever talk about. How she's happy and you aren't. I fell in love with you because you were satisfied. I guess now the tables have turned.
Is everything all right?
I'm not going to brunch. Tell your brother.
We've had this argument before. Different day, different beginning, but the same message. Alice, I don't know how she's managing to do this, to slip into my home and tear apart my marriage, but she has all these times. Well, maybe George is right. Maybe I am crazy. I've certainly given him enough reason to think so. But that doesn't matter anymore. I've got to pull myself together. I've got to stay strong. For family. For me.
Are we really not going to brunch?
Well, your father doesn't want to, but if you want to get the brother, the three of us can.
Really?
Really, I mean it. Oh, before you go, dear.
Yeah, Mom?
How would you feel about possibly going out for your birthday? You and I, and maybe another friend, and her mother. We can make it a ladies' day.
I'd like that. A lot.
Me too. Now, go get your brother.
You three are still going out?
You can join us, if you like.
No. I have a meeting with a friend of mine. Have a good day.
George, what aren't you telling me?
Already.
Good. Let's get our coats on. Margaret here?
No, she went out about 20 minutes ago. She's celebrating Holly's birthday, so she shouldn't be back for a while.
Oh, George, you wouldn't believe the week I've had. I've been so stressed.
Never mind that now. Would you like a drink?
You know me too well.
Well, I've known you long enough. Alice. You have never failed to amaze me.
Never?
Never.
Guess that's why you always come back.
Me? You're the one who's come to my apartment, Alice, dear.
And that gives you the advantage?
Well, certainly gives me something. Bragging rights, maybe. Either way, it gives me you. Tell me, Alice, why do you keep coming back?
I don't know. Maybe it makes me feel free to be having an affair.
Don't say it like that. It makes it sound like a bad thing.
Wouldn't Margaret and John think so?
Margaret and John aren't here. I don't know what we were thinking when we started this. We probably weren't thinking. But these past few months have been the happiest time I've had in years. Margaret's been so lifeless lately. But you,
You're alive, Alice. Alive with me.
Don't get all sappy on me now. You know I can't handle the sappy parts. But I do know what you mean. It's like for a few moments we're like teenagers running around behind our parents' backs again. It's freeing.
Jesus Christ! Margaret, I
leave!
Get out!
Margaret, it's not—
Stop!
Margaret, please—
I don't want to hear it!
I'm sorry!
No, I'm sorry! I guess I should apologize for walking in on what was clearly an intimate moment.
Can we at least talk about this?
No, we can't. I thought you loved me, George, but obviously you didn't care enough to not kiss my sister.
I'm trying to explain. Won't you at least stay and listen?
Listen to what? Listen to you tell me you love me while you call my suspicions crazy? Listen to you tell me I have no reason to be jealous over Alice? You loved her first, George. Don't think I've forgotten.
I'm sorry. I guess I just didn't realize how far things had gone.
Was that all that happened? Just one kiss?
No. It's not. I'm sorry.
Let's go.
Margaret, please.
Pack your things. I didn't think it would hurt as much the second time around, but it does. The signs were all there. How could I not see it? All the going behind my back. What I thought was an attempt to have me labeled as hysterical was actually my marriage going up in flames. The signs were all there. Eyes always darting to the clock after a fight. Phone calls at all hours of the night, late night drinks with friends I've never met. And Alice, she practically told me that she was still in love with him. I was right all along, and now what do I have to show for it? God damn it, George!
Margaret, please, I need to talk to you.
Fine, make it quick.
All right, you asked for it. So you and I both know what's been going on now, and I know it's been going on for a long time.
How long?
Months, right under our noses and behind our backs.
And Alice told you all of this?
Yes, she came home yesterday in hysterics, and by the time I could get her to calm down, she told me everything.
Everything?
Yes, they've been seeing each other for months now. They've always had eyes for each other, that's undeniable. And with Alice so worried about James in Vietnam, and George so worried about you, they finally had motivation to start something.
What do you mean, worried about me? Why should George be worried about me? He's the one with the problem.
Now, Margaret, you know I don't mean any ill harm, but even you can't deny the facts. You've gone hysterical lately. Half of what you say makes no sense whatsoever.
How dare you?
Look, I didn't come here to start fights. I came here because your husband has been sleeping with my wife.
Congratulations, you're a lucky winner. You figured out what I've known all along.
You knew?
Of course I knew, John. How could I not?
Why didn't you tell me?
I've had my suspicions for months. Sure, they may have started in the wrong place, but I knew something was happening.
Why didn't you give me a chance?
What would I have said? My own husband called me crazy when I said I wasn't happy with my life. How would you have reacted if I said they were having an affair?
I would have given you a chance,
Mom. Bullshit! I'm sorry, but I'm going to have to ask you to leave.
But Margaret—
Just go! What the hell does he know anyway? I don't know, John. He and Alice went out on the train to God knows where while she went off to visit an ex. And even then, he's hardly spoken to me without her being there. What the hell? I know how this goes. I know how I felt. And now, I still feel that way. I thought I was over this, over that burning, empty feeling in my chest. To know that the two people I love the most in the world had betrayed me, like I meant nothing to them. Ruby did always hate George. She did always say I'd be better off without him. And Ruby always looked out for my well-being, didn't she? She was right. I would be better off without him. Without George. It's all so simple now. Looking back, I don't know why I didn't think of it sooner. And it would be so easy, too. George keeps a box in the junk gun in a box under the bed. He keeps it loaded, too, just in case.
No, no! What am I saying? I can't do this! George is right, I am crazy! I can't do this! I can't!
Thank you again. I'm so glad we could get through this. All of us.
Well, you know how it goes. We're family. And family sticks together through thick and thin. I suppose it's you and I who should be thanking John and Margaret. I just can't believe we've married such forgiving people. Ah, there she is. We were just saying goodbye. Come join us.
Of course.
Well, it's getting late. We should be going. Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.
I'll walk you to the elevator.
Me too.
It's been so nice having you two over. Margaret and I better offer you a hug goodbye.
It's not them I'll be saying goodbye to. Come on, come on, just fire already. Why won't you do anything? Of course, the blood is on my hands. What else would I expect? All the sick and twisted ironies. Why did everything stop? God, even the clock stopped its ticking. This isn't what I expected to happen. I thought I could just get it done and over with. It won't shoot. Of all the things that could go different, except the goddamn gun won't shoot. I wonder if it would shoot even if time wasn't frozen. I swear to God I loaded it, but that's just how it goes here, isn't it? What's the point? I know how this goes. I shoot George in the back. I can already tell he's dead when I turn the gun on myself. I don't even know why I did it. I didn't intend to. It just happened. I just wanted to create a better life for myself and my children. Alice and John were there. They watched. Alice had to see her own sister shoot her husband and herself. But why? I could have just waited until they were in the elevator with Michael and Holly. Couldn't I have? But what good would it have done? They still would have heard it. And Michael and Holly must have heard it when I shot George. They had to listen to their parents die. Why did I kill you, George? You can't answer me. You're dead. And I'm dead. And this isn't even you. This is all in my head. I killed you because I was miserable. But now I'm stuck here and had to be miserable all over again. Why did I kill you, George? I love you. I always have. But as we got older, things didn't work. I didn't work. You were right. There were things I could have done. It was my fault that everything turned into an argument. It was my fault that we never went to counseling to get help. And now it's my fault that you're dead. It's true, you know. The blood is on my hands. I did this. It's my fault. I know why I'm here now. I had to see it again. I had to learn that I was what was making my life so miserable. I know that now. I love you, George. I understand now, and I'm ready to go.
Chances are chances are your chances.